and welcome to the Morningstar series, Why Should I Invest With You? I'm Emma Wall and I'm joined today by Alex Crooke, manager of the Bankers Investment Trust. Hi, Alex.
Hello.
So the Bankers Investment Trust has managed to grow its dividend for the last 50 years. How have you and previous managers managed to pull that off?
There's a couple of things. The first one is the structure of an investment trust allows us to retain some revenue, some dividends in the good years, and then we can pay it out in the more difficult years when maybe some companies are cutting dividends. So we have revenue reserves. And Bankers has almost 2 years of clear dividend in reserves. So again, that allows us, I think, to pick markets when we favour lower yielding markets over high yielding. We can switch the asset allocation and still pay out, as you say, that consecutive growth in dividends. And the second aspect, I think, is just stock picking. We try and buy companies that grow their dividends, because if they grow dividends to us as investors, we can pass that on to our shareholders.
And it is a global trust, but predominantly, well, there's about 30-33% in the UK. I was wondering, is that something that's indicative of the fund style, or is that because you continue to see the greatest opportunities in domestic stocks?
I think it's probably more historical. The UK is a very international market in terms of the listed companies. Everybody probably knows that, the FTSE 100 of largest companies. A lot of international companies there. So we get our international exposure through the UK sometimes with high dividends. The dividend yields are good. And we've got some security in terms of the accounting, the governance of, as well, of companies being listed here. But I think life is changing and markets in China and Asia are growing bigger and getting more companies listed there. And I think over time, therefore, we feel more confident in pushing our asset allocation to own these companies in their domestic markets.
And you've got US stocks, you've got Japanese stocks, you've got some German, France, some Hong Kong, some China. Mm. Sort of, if you group them together, two of the largest regions you have exposure to are Europe as a whole and Japan, both of which have this backdrop now of negative interest rates and maybe even more cuts to come. How does that affect you as an income investor?
It would be challenging if we just owned bonds, because in those markets, clearly, as you say, a negative interest rate means you're actually almost paying to store your money with banks. We're not. We're equity investors. And the equity market, I think, is being well supported by these actions. So the idea is to get companies to use their cash to invest and therefore hopefully create growth in the future. And so I think actually it's quite positive. We try and look forward, not necessarily the next month, the next quarter, but 1-2 years out. Where should we have our investments to yield a positive return for our investors over that time frame? And I think both markets, Japan and Europe, will see strong dividend growth. We'll see recovery in earnings because of this government and central bank action. So I'm positive on both regions for dividend growth as well.
Alex, thank you very much.
It's a pleasure.
This is Emma Wall from Morningstar. Thank you for watching.